Page 24, the track meet. This is a march, like a pep rally to get people, yeah, let's go do something wonderful or something. 3/4 time, one sharp, or in the key of G major. So make sure you do the G major scale and the E minor scale and the arpeggios to match G major and E minor. You know the drill. I've said it on each video. Just cause I got videos on. Go do the stuff in the video. Beginner and intermediate level. Yeah, it's good enough. Let's take it one hand at a time. Make sure we're okay with fingering and all. I don't think the rhythm's a problem. At the beginning, at one end, two end. Come down to the same fingers. Then reach up. One. And 2/5. Now come up. 1/2. Then 5, come down. 4. See, that's just a broken chord. Now reach up. I do a 1/2 here. This is the third line down, third measure, because it's closer. You don't have to do a 3. And then go up 4. And here, if you can't get your hand up in here for the last line there on page 24, you gotta do that. That's awkward, the pedal of hell, but if you can, use the fingering in the book. And 5. And that, there. Next last measure on page 24. It's a 1 and a 1 with that little square bracket. That means you play both notes with the thumb. We do that quite a bit in piano. It's okay. 1/3 there in the second measure of page 25. That way you can reach this little easier. Then you do it again. That's basically what it is. 1/3/4 here. The little finger is ready for the G up above. And I do a 5/4/5. You do whatever finger you want. I just don't like using the same finger all the time. Don't forget the F sharp. That's a broken chord, and that's the fingering for it. I like that. And I do it there at the bottom of page 25. So at the bottom is thumb, and then 2/5, 1/4, come across 2/5, just use that as your pivot and come across, 1/4. And then up here, and here. A lot going on there. This isn't piano music, but it's kind of nice. It's a challenge to get this. It helps. It'll help to develop your technique and to get ready for more difficult music coming. It really will, yeah. Left hands. And then on this third measure, I do a 1/2/1. The thumb doesn't need to do it all. No. 2. And broken chords. To think about in the right hand, so it's nice that the left hand isn't that challenging. Let's put them together and what happens. And again, don't worry about hesitating. And then here, and here. The chord, make sure you got all the right notes. It's a 7th chord, so it sounds a little off, but that's okay because it's going to resolve here. About as hard as it gets. Once you get comfortable with the notes and all, you don't have to go fast yet, just no hesitations. You can think about the articulation. You're down, staccato, wrist staccato here. To neutral, hang on to that for the full beat and just a hair longer, and then a sforzando. The sforzando is the biggest accent you can have. It's the strongest accent. It's a musical bang. Now don't get stiff when the wrist goes. It's got to be a musical bang. It's just very loud. And now you're loud in the right hand and keep the left hand in the background. Whatever you think loud is, don't get very loud, just loud. you have to lift up anyway. I want to hear the phrasing. By itself. It's a pep rally. Of course you're loud. You're going to be loud throughout the whole thing. At the end, the last measure is staccato. With a marcato is a stronger accent than a regular accent, but not as strong as a sforzando. So, as far as the speed goes, it's a march. You want to feel it. You can play accurately first, so don't go beyond that, but what you have, what can you do accurately? And then, of course, they've added pedal. Well, we can use some help with the pedal to help connect things we can't help with the fingers. And it's also kind of nice to have the overtones, to have more going on. And because it's loud, it's rather quick. I'm going to use, when I push the pedal down like at the beginning, I'm going to push the pedal down right with the notes, not after. But I'm still going to do the syncopated pedal when I change pedal. I'll change pedal right after I play the notes. You have to be careful with that because this goes so quickly. If you're not right with the pedal, you'll lose the note because you'll already play the note and let up before you get the pedal down. What you can do to fix that is finger pedal the first note in the left hand. Start with the second line here. Finger pedal, hold that down for a second. That way you're sure to catch it with the pedal. Otherwise, if you're too late with the pedal, you'll miss that note. So you might finger pedal the first beat of those broken chords in the left hand throughout. So at the beginning, it's this connects them. Lift up right as you play the notes. And I like to hear the rest. You can pedal that note if you want the quarter note. Just put the pedal down with the hands and lift up. And then here. And then it's overlapping. And I don't pedal on the second line last measure. I don't pedal the first two beats. I want to hear the phrase. And then I can pedal. So then on the last measure, the third line again. I don't pedal the first two beats. I want to hear the phrase. Actually, you don't need to pedal that measure at all. It's just one note. And then going on, you can pedal. And then at the end of that line, you don't need to pedal that measure. The last measure on page 24, you don't need to pedal that. You can pedal the first two beats, I guess you don't need to. And on the last measure of the first line on page 25, I don't pedal the first two beats. I want to hear the phrase. Now you pedal and then change it. Of these, I'm not pedaling the last measure or the pickup. It depends on what's happening. If I want the overtones, I'm going to pedal it. If I don't need the overtones, I'm not going to pedal it. Listen to very carefully what's going on in the sound, and you decide when you're going to pedal and when you're not going to pedal. Marcia is like a march, is this? That's fine. Take it at your speed, but it needs to be a steady. Remember, you're at a pep rally. Don't be going in there and then suddenly hesitating somewhere. It throws them off.